Hey, welcome back. We're still working in Module 6. We're all the way down now to Section 5, where I want to talk to you a little bit about borders and shading. You probably noticed when we were working on the table that you had borders automatically. As soon as you inserted the table, you have black borders that print. Well, I told you that you have the option to take those off. You can actually add different borders if you'd like, just to really enhance your tables. So let me show you a little bit about how borders and shading work. One of the things we talked about was when you first insert a table, you automatically will have borders around that table. Borders do print. So if you don't want them, you can take them off. You can actually add different types of borders, different styles, colors, things like that. I'm going to select this table, and I'm under the Table Tools Contextual tab, the Design tab here, and you can see this is your borders grouping. I'm going to start with this Borders button here. First of all, you'll notice that several of these look like they're turned on. This will allow you to put a border around the bottom of your selection, the top, left, right. If you don't want one of these, you just click on to turn it off. Here's how you take the border totally off, no border. And if you do that, you'll notice now you have gray, what they call grid lines. Now, grid lines do not print, they're just there to show you the outlines of your cells. Just so you'll know, if you don't even want to see the grid lines, then you can actually go and turn the view for those on or off under the same Borders button. See how it says View Grid Lines here? Well, if I click on that, now they're off. Now it looks like there's nothing there, but the table's still there, your cells still work the same way. It just really would look like nice neat columns of information versus a table. I'll go ahead and put these back on. I'm going to choose the Outside Border option. And I'd also like to view those grid lines so that I can work with them a little bit easier. I'll go down here and choose View Grid Lines. Do you notice when I chose Outside Border, there's only a border that will print on the outside of my table? Now I want to apply a border around my header only. So I'll select the first line, go back to Design, and I'm going to choose again Outside Border, but this time it'll be just for the header. So borders are only around your selection, not necessarily each cell in your selection. Notice on this list that you can also apply inside horizontal or inside vertical borders, and then you've got some diagonal ones you can apply that go sideways like this, and then you can also put in a horizontal line. So those are your basic border options. That's kind of nice, but did you notice we can't really pick a color here or a style, so that's where it really gets interesting. I'm going to go to the bottom of the list where it says Borders and Shading and click. Now you'll notice that I have Border Options, Page Border Options, and Shading Options. So I'm going to start with the Border Options. Over here on the left, you can quickly just choose a box if you like. You can choose All, which just puts a line between each of your columns here, or a grid. But here's where I can choose a style for my border. I can pick a color for my border and also a width, which is like a thickness. What you have to do here is after you pick all these options, go into the preview area and click on the borders you want to be that style and color. If you don't do this and you just click OK, nothing's going to happen. Notice that if I wanted to take a border off, I just click back on it, and that way I can change it. So if I wanted the sides here to be different for some reason, I can pick a different border totally, different colors, different width, and then I can click on those, and now you can see that all of the borders look a little different. Let me go ahead and click OK, and now you'll see that my header has this specific style of border. Now let's say that I want to go ahead and apply something a little different to the bottom two rows here. I'll just go back to Design and be really creative with this. Let's say that I do want to have this particular one. See how the last style that you chose is here? So I don't have to go back to Borders and all the way through that whole option if I don't want to do that. So I can go ahead if I want and go ahead and choose this style. And there's border styles here as well. So if you like some of these, you can certainly choose those. So I'm going to go ahead and go back into this arrow, which is another way to get back in here, and I'm going to go ahead and apply the same style to all four for now. So you see how it's based on your selection. Let's talk a little bit about the shading. The shading is going to be the color or whatever you put inside of the background of your object. I'll just go ahead and put some shading in the bottom two here. When I go back to Design, go back into the arrow again, the last tab over says Shading, and this is where we apply a fill. A fill is whatever's inside the background of your object. So let's say that I decide I want to put a color in here. I'll just do a light blue, and I'll go ahead and click OK and see what it looks like. Okay, let me go ahead and apply a shading to my header here. I'll go back to Design, back into the Borders and Shading, and this time I'm going to get more colors. I didn't like any of those. And let's say that I choose one of these lighter options here and click OK. Now I want you to notice also that you can have a pattern. First of all, the color that you chose, right now it's called clear, and you can see there's a percentage. That means that the color I have, I can make it a little bit lighter, a little bit darker by choosing one of these percentages. But if I keep going to the bottom of the list, you'll see there's also some different pattern styles I can choose from. You can't always read your text very well if you pick some of these, so you want to use some that maybe the spacing is a little different here. You can kind of see these. And then you can pick a color for the stripe, for the check, that sort of thing, if you need to do that. Let's see what this looks like. So you can kind of tell right there, I've got some stripes back there, I've got that lighter color, and then I've got the color of those particular stripes. You can play with this all day long and come up with all kinds of scenarios. Now I want to show you one more quick thing, because I mentioned that borders and shading aren't just for tables, you can also use them for text. Let me flip over to another exercise we have and just show you real quick. This is Burke Edit, and you'll notice that they have a title and a subtitle here. And let's say that I'd like to put these two in the center, and I want to put a border and shading around those. I'll just select those, and I told you that under the Home tab, these are borders and shading options here as well. I'm going to go ahead and choose the border option. I'll go down to borders and shading, and I'll just pick a couple of different options in here. I'll pick this. Let's say I pick a different color. I'll pick this green, and let's say I put a little shading in here. We'll put a lighter color if we can, and I'll click OK. And now I'll go ahead and center the text, maybe change the font, things like that that I might want. But what you notice is that you now have borders and shading around your text. So just remember that borders and shading work for text, and it works for tables as well. It's just your selection. One last thing we saw in the borders and shading option, we had page borders. I'm going to go back into this and go down to borders and shading. The middle tab said page border. Here's where if you want to put a border around the entire page, you've got the same options, but now you also have art available. So here's where you're going to have all kinds of artwork that you can apply to the border of your particular page. Now some of these look like little cute little graphics. At the bottom they have some that are a little more professional. So if you needed something that was just more of a line, you can see some of these. But let me just go ahead and pick something fun so you can see how it works. I'll just go back and pick these balloons right here, and I'll click OK. And now you'll see that's the border around your page. So you've got options for putting borders around your information you have selected and around the page itself, and that's going to be on every page. So that's going to wrap up your borders and shading. Just have a lot of fun with that. Get really creative. Let's go over into Section 6 now and talk about sorting your information that you have in your tables.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right. I'll see you next week with additional videos.